In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Good morning and a very warm welcome this morning to our church, St. Michael's, for all those who have joined us here in the body of church and all those that also continue to join us online. A very warm welcome. This Sunday, we come to the midpoint of Lent. The season is half over, and the celebration of the death and resurrection of Jesus is nearer to us. On this midway Sunday, it is traditional to honour mothers, praying for those still with us and remembering those who have died. So let us take a few moments now to remember times when we have failed to show love to those close to us and to bring our sins to the one who is generous with love and mercy.
Christians, people may hasten toward the solemn celebrations too. man from the house of Levi went and married a Levite woman. The woman conceived and bore a late son. And when she saw that he was a fine baby, she hid him 3 months. When she could hide him no longer, she got a papyrus basket for him and plastered it with bitumen and pitch. She put the child in it and placed it on the reeds on the bank of the river. His sister stood at a distance to see what would happen to him. The daughter of Pharaoh came down to bathe at the river while her attendants walked beside the river. She saw the basket among the reeds and sent her maid to bring it. When she opened it, she saw the child. He was crying, and she took pity on him. "This must be one in which you bring children," she said. And his sister said to Pharaoh's daughter, "Shall I go and get you a nurse from the Hebrew woman to nurse the child for you?" Pharaoh's daughter said to her, "Yes." So the girl went and informed the child's mother. Pharaoh's daughter said to her, "Take this child and nurse it for me, and I will give you your wages." So the woman took the child and nursed it. When the child grew up, she bore him to Pharaoh's daughter, and she took him as her son. She named him Moses. "Because," she said, "I drew him out of the water." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all consolation, who consoles us in all our affliction, so that we may be able to console those who are in all affliction with the consolation with which we ourselves are consoled by God. For just as the sufferings of Christ are abundant for us, so also our consolation is abundant for Christ. If we are being afflicted, it is for your consolation and salvation. If we are being consoled, it is for your consolation, which you experience through the patient individual the same sufferings that we have also suffered. Our hope for you is unshaken, for we know that as you share in our sufferings, you also share in our consolation.
Jesus said to Nicodemus, "The Son of Man must be lifted up as Moses lifted up the serpent in the desert, so that everyone who believes may have eternal life in him." Yes, God loved the world so much that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not be lost, but may have eternal life. For God sent his Son into the world, not to condemn the world, but so that through him the world might be saved. No one who believes in him will be condemned, but whoever refuses to believe is condemned already, because he has refused to believe in the name of God's only Son. On these grounds is sentence pronounced, that through the light, that though the light has come into the world, men have shown they preferred darkness to the light because their deeds were evil. And indeed, everybody who does wrong hates the light and avoids it, for fear his actions should be exposed. But the man who lives by the truth comes out into that light so that it may be plainly seen that what he does is done in God. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I speak in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. A teacher once asked a boy a question. The teacher said, "Suppose your mother baked a pie. and there were seven of you, your mum, your dad, and five children, what part of the pie would you get? So, there's a pie, there's seven people, it's being split up. Can anybody give me an answer? Maybe the children might be giving an answer.
1/7.
Well, do you know, the boy said a sixth. The boy said a sixth. So the teacher said, I'm afraid you don't know your fractions. Remember, there are seven of you. Yes, teacher, said the boy. So therefore, that means you would get a seventh, just like you said. But the boy said, yes, but teacher, you don't know my mum. Mum would say she wouldn't want any pie. The most creative job in the world, I think this is. It involves fashion, decorating, recreation, particularly recently, education, transportation, psychology and counselling, romance, cuisine, literature, art, economics, government, pediatrics, geriatrics, entertainment, maintenance, purchasing, law, religion, energy, and management. Anybody who can handle all of that has to be somebody special. Can anybody tell me who I'm thinking of? What job do we know that has all that in? Well done. That is the job of a mother. A mother does all of those things and probably more. It truly is one of the world's most creative jobs. I have another story. A teacher gave her class a lesson and she said, I'm going to test you on the lesson I gave yesterday. And I'm going to test you all without getting the lesson. See if you can guess this one, okay? So this is, I am an object. I have two different colours at either end. That was the bit they got the day before. Now then, my name has six letters. The first one is M. And when you have me, I pick things up. Anybody have an idea what the lesson was? It was a physics lesson. She was teaching an object that picks things up and begins with M and is six letters. What could that be? Does anybody know? Usually it comes in a block with a colour on this side and a colour on this side. Or you can get it in a horseshoe shape. Well done. It was a magnet. So all these children have been taught this lesson all day about a magnet, about how it works within physics, how it picks things up. And the next day, she asked the same question again. And she said, so, everybody who can tell me what I am? My full name has six letters. The first one is M, and I pick things up. What am I? Can anybody guess what they might have said today? Mother. Absolutely. In fact, when the test papers were returned, almost half of the students, even though they had the magnet lesson the day before, all said mother. And I think we all know, our poor mothers have spent a lot of time picking things up. The reason I've told you these things, of course, is because today is a special day. Who could tell me what the day is today? Mother's Day. Mother's Day, that's right, or Mothering Sunday. And the reason why we say Mothering Sundays a bit more here is because it's not just about mothers, it's about mothering in general. What do I mean by that? Well, it could be that we receive our mothering from somebody else. We could receive it from our grandma. We could receive it from our stepmom. We could receive it from our older sister. It also goes to other parts of mothering as well. Our church, our mother church. Mary, our mother. And Mother Earth. The Mother Earth that gives us all of the resources through the grace of God. So there's lots of parts to mothering. But of course, particularly today, we also do remember our mothers, whether they're still with us or whether they've gone beyond to join our Lord. We still actually remember those today too. So put your hands up if you were lucky enough to have your mum around so that you could give her a card or a present today. Who gave a card or a present to their mum today? Okay, so we've got a fair few that they actually managed to give their card or present to their mum today. Well done. So, the card that I sent my mum, because I'm from Wales, I don't call her mum. That's an English thing. We call her ma'am. And it's really hard to find a card that says ma'am. But it is my mission every year to search out a card that says ma'am. And my card said, ma'am, I love you. Do you think your mum likes to hear us tell her that we love her? What do you think, yeah? Put your hand up if you tell your mum you love her. Fantastic. Well done. There's something else, though, that I was thinking about. When I was thinking about telling my mum that I love her, I was thinking, do you know what? There's something probably she'd like more from me than just telling her that I love her. What else do you think she might like from me and your mums might like from you over and above just telling her that you love her? What do you think it might be? Yes, I'm not going to disagree with any of those. I think you're right, actually. I think we could go with quite a few things. So there's definitely chocolate. I mean, that's high on the list. Gin, possibly higher. Flowers. What do you think we could do? Give her a hug. Do you know, that's right. But what does that hug do? If we tell her that we love her and then we give her a hug, what do you think that hug does? Anybody? Confirms it. It shows her, doesn't it? So does the gin and the chocolates, mind you. Okay, it really does. When I get gin, I'm like, oh, I feel loved. The thing is, we want to tell our mums that we love them, but also, you know, we want to show our mums that we love them. Come to the end now. I'd just like to ask you to bow your heads. We say a short prayer. Dear Jesus, we thank you for all mothers and those who care for us around the world and all that they do for their children. We thank you for their patience when we don't get things right. We thank you for their encouragement when we find life hard. We pray that mums would feel really special today, and that you would remind us every day to show them just as much as we tell them that we love them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us stand to confess our faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified on his life, he suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge our baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead. Power of the Spirit, and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father.
Father, we pray for your church. Strengthen her and guide her. We pray for Christians everywhere, and especially those who persecuted for their faith. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Let us care for this planet you have given us. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for our country, for Elizabeth, our Queen. May we care for each other. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for this parish, Father in heaven and each other, for our mothers on this special day, those of you.
We pray for the sick, heal them and help them, for the people we know, Jonathan, Harriet, Liz, Adam, Jean, Bob, Jeff, Ian, Martin, Anani, Steve, Nick, Tish, Becky and family, Gerald, Alison and family, Lord in your mercy.
We read to you those who have left this life, for those whose mothers have died and find today difficult. We remember Willie, Mary and Joe, who have died recently, and for Arthur Clive, Harold Council, Aubrey Spells, Christopher Robinson, May Saunders, Ernest Warner Priest, Alexander Brown, Sister Frances, Mabel Baker, Bill Williams, Amina Simmons, Jack Burton, and Beatrice Banks, if she is mine, of course, this week. Grant them a place of rest and peace. Lord, in your mercy.
We pray for the angels and saints and Mary, our mother as we greet her. Hail Mary, full of grace.
Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not at our sins, but on the faith of your Church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your holy will. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us offer one another a socially distant sign of peace.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters in Christ, that this sacrifice, which is both yours and mine, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. The mystery of faith. Rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and for looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on Martin, our bishop, and on all your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Joseph, her spouse, St. Michael the Archangel, St. Wilfrid, St. Richard of Chichester, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord. By whom and with whom and in Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and behold Jesus, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. So first of all, a very warm welcome back. It's absolutely lovely to see so many people in church, and we're still able to manage the social distancing being such a large building, so that's fantastic. And if I can just remind you, because of the current restrictions that we're still under, that at the end of Mass, if you can please leave directly and not mingle at the back of church, because as lovely as it is for us to see each other again, I'm afraid we have to continue to abide by the rules for the time being. We hope and pray that that comes to an end soon. It appears we have two birthdays. Yesterday was Michael Timmins' birthday, and today is Hugh in the choir, Hugh Fisher's birthday. I wonder if we could sing them a happy birthday, actually. That'd be really nice. Michael said that he would actually have loved to have invited us all back into the hall for a glass of bubbly, but clearly it's not that's not allowed. However, there is some simnel cake for you to take away, which was very kindly organised, so we can celebrate with you. Thank you. If I can now invite the children to come forward to collect a posy. We'll just say a quick prayer of blessing over the posies before we have them out. Thank you very much for a nice flashy blue food gloves. Let us pray. Almighty God, we pray that you will accept these flowers as a sign of our appreciation of all that comes from motherhood. From the motherhood of the church, the motherhood of our planet, and the motherhood of Mary. And especially today, we pray that as we ask you to bless these flowers, that they may be a sign of our gratitude, our warmth, and especially our love for our mothers in our lives today. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I don't know if I feel like a dentist with a mask on. Anyway, never mind. Thank you very much. Right, if I can invite children to come forward and collect a posy for their mum. Don't be shy. Now that I'm very aware very aware that we all have mothers, not just the children, of course. And some of us also may appreciate to have a posy to drop around to a mother's resting place, should she no longer be with us too. So, as we continue, Simon will now be dropping around some flowers to everybody so that you've all got some. So, everybody will get a posy, at least. And if you do know of a next door neighbour who really could do the posy because there isn't anybody, then please, if there's any leftover, help yourself as well. I want to make sure that we show these as a sign of our thoughts, our prayers, and our love for all those. The best not forget my wife. I invite
you all now to please stand for the blessing and dismiss.
The Lord be with you. Lord, look upon those who called me and sustain me. Give life by your unfailing light to those who walk in the shadow of death, and bring those rescued by your mercy from every evil to reach the highest good. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you now and remain with you and your homes always.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Go in
peace.
Of the Lord.